আরাধিতো যদি হরি তপসাস্ততস্কিম নারাধিতো হরিহি যদি হরিহি তপসাস্ততস্কিম অন্তর্বহির যদি হরিহি স্ততস্কিম তপসাস্ততস্কিম নান্তর্বহির যদি হরিহি তপসাস্ততস্কিম শিশিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাদ টোল্ড দ্যাট টু ডু হরিনাম অ্যাড টু মিট উইথ কৃষ্ণা অল দ্য সেম শিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাদ টোল্ড টু ডু হরিনাম অ্যান্ড টু মিট উইথ কৃষ্ণা ডাইরেক্টলি অল দ্য সেম অ্যাকচুয়ালি ট্রান্সেন্ডেন্টাল সাউন্ড ইজ সো হাই থিং কমন পিপল দে ক্যান নট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড ফার্স্ট অফ অল আই উড লাইক টু সে ইন দ্য ইয়ার অফ 1914 ওয়েন ভক্তিবিনোদ ঠাকুর গন ফ্রম দিস মেটেরিয়াল ওয়ার্ল্ড ইন দ্য ইয়ার অফ 1914 Bhaktivinoda Thakur just gone from this material world. But before going from this material world, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving instruction to Prabhupada Bimala Prasad Saraswati Prabhupada that you will have to start Dham Parikram. You will have to start Navadip Dham Parikram through Parikram. Thousands of people can get benefit out of that. And we will have to install Daiva Varnashram, without which we are almost aimless, doing haphazard anything we are doing, without any meaning. This way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving instruction to Prabhupada to start Dham Parikram. And actually, Prabhupada started Dham Parikram with so many devotees, they are coming in Dham. Because Dham is more and more merciful than deity. Dham is very, very merciful because Dham Tattva is Baladev Tattva. Baladev is more and more merciful. That's why সহস্র প্রথম কমলম গোকুলাক্ষম মহৎপদম তৎকরণিকারম তৎ অনন্তাংশ সম্ভব ফ্রম ব্রহ্মসংহিতা অপ্রাকৃত দাম ইনো রেস্টিং প্লেস অফ কৃষ্ণ আই মিন অপ্রাকৃত দাম ইজ অল বলদেব তত্ত্ব ইউনো বলদেব নিত্যানন্দ বলরাম সার্ভিং কৃষ্ণ ইন 12 ডিফারেন্ট ফর্ম থ্রোন in which Krishna is going to sit, pillow, Krishna, a ballav, yagapavit, skirt thread, baldev, karam, I mean, karam, you know, paduka, shoes, balaram, everything balaram. So you see, balaram serving Krishna in 12 different way, but still, regarding Srishti Tattva, regarding creation, Balavji Maharaj also helping in different way. You all know this point. Actually, Balavji Maharaj, Karunanava Sai Mahavishnu, infinity material world resting in him. Yashaika Nisheshito Kalu Mathavalambo জীবন্তি লোম বিলজা জগদণ্ডনাথ বিষ্ণুর মহানস ইহো ইয়স্য কলা বিশেষ গোবিন্দমাদি পুরুষম তমহম ভজামি প্রম্বম সংহিতা ইনফিনিটি মেটেরিয়াল ওয়ার্ল্ড রেস্টিং ইন মহাবিষ্ণু অ্যান্ড ইফ ইউ গো আপ মহাবিষ্ণু আফটার দ্যাট কারণমসাই মহাবিষ্ণু আফটার দ্যাট গর্ভদো সাই মহাবিষ্ণু আফটার দ্যাট ক্ষীরোদ গোসাই মহাবিষ্ণু all jivatma. Actually, Kshirodha Gosai Mahavishnu, Aniruddha Vishnu, all jivatma, small particles, chidatma, coming from this, resting in Kshirodha Gosai Mahavishnu. And actually, inside Vrindavan Dham, Mool Vallav, the original Vallav, he is playing with Krishna. His first time always playing with Krishna is almost equal to Krishna. Why I say almost? Because Vallavji Maharaj at the same time serving to Krishna, at the same time he is his pastime is just like, you know, playing Leela also like Krishna. Follow? Like Balaji Maharaj can do Ras. No other incarnation of Krishna can do Ras, only Balaji. Because Balaji is second expansion, first expansion, not second expansion. First expansion of Krishna, Swayangrupa Bhagavan Krishna. So he is acting as, you know, Guru Tattva, he is serving Krishna. At the same time, Balaji Maharaj is, he can do Ras, everything this way. So, Balaji Maharaj, you see, acting in original Mool Sankarshan. After that, Mahasankarshan in Chaturbuha, four square there, outside, you know, Dham. Because inside Vrindavan, outside, just outside Mathura, more outside there is Dwarka, after that Shetadip, in which you are sitting now. This is a Shetadip where you are sitting now. Shetadip is just, you see, is the appendix of Krishna Lila. Shetadip is a total explanation in which Gauranga Mahaprabhu playing, doing pastime. Actually, point is that Gaur Lila is the complete explanation of Krishna Lila. If you want to understand Krishna Lila directly, you cannot understand properly. So you will have to go through Gaur Lila. You have to go Gaur Lila. And now this is Shetadip in which you are doing Sankirtan, doing Bhakti, nine different part, you see. I can give some discussion about it. Tomorrow I can speak in details. Actually, Dham Tattva is very unique tattva. If you are not going to get any kippa from anywhere, then ultimately you can depend upon Dham. Dham can give you kippa, more merciful. You can remember Jagai Madai, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving excuse them, but still after that, they are begging for seva. Then they received seva of Dhamma, in a cleaning of Dham. In Madai Ghat, you see, they are cleaning Dham. And those people, Brahman and Vaishnava, used to come before to take bath. They, actually, a big pap, you see, they have done big pap before. So anybody coming there to take bath in Ghat, Jagai Madai Ghat, Barakona Ghat actually, they are, you know, paying prostrate at Dandavat, at the same time crying, excuse us, you see, actually previously we couldn't know what kind of problem we have done for you all, please excuse us. This way they are praying and cleaning Ghat all the time. So actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving this seva of Dham. Actually, I also told in Puri that Asatthama, you know what kind of apradh he have done? Big apradh. Asatthama killing five, you know, sons of Panchapandav, five. But after that, Krishna not at all ready to excuse to Asatthama. But then, actually, Aswatthama took decision by the advice of one rishi that you go to Vrindavan and sharp dham. Today or tomorrow, anyhow, Krishna is bound to give you kripa. So, Aswatthama still today doing bhajan, near Nandagram. Is doing bhajan there near Nandagram. Actually, his village name is Pisai Gaon. There, actually, he is doing bhajan still today to get kripa of Bhagavan Sri Krishna. This way, see, by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by the advice of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada started Dham Parikrama. All devotees, poor, any devotees, they are coming at the time of Gaur Purnim. Then Prabhupada arranged their parikrama first. You know, under the guidance of Ishan Thakur and previously under the guidance of Nityananda Prabhu, this Dham Parikrama was done. Who did this Dham Parikrama? Jiva Goswami Pad. So you see, why when Jagadananda Pandit going to Vrindavan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, again I am coming to Gaur Leela, and one vital point that today is my topic, so I can speak after. Little Dham Parikrama going on, so I can speak something about it. Actually, Jagadananda Pandit is the eternal Parshad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. From very childhood, used to play with Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Now actually, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started living in Dham, Nilachal Dham, then Jagadananda Pandit went there and started staying with Prabhu and serving Prabhu there. But actually, Jagadananda Pandit actually doing this kind of seva there, in Puri, there. He is serving Gauranga Mahaprabhu in different way. Relation is very sweet. He is writing so nice book. His name is Prem Bivarta. The way of prema is zigzag, like snack. Ahe ribo gatihi premna sabhava kutilo bhavet. The way of prema is very zigzag. I can discuss this point after. Actually, now, when Gauranga Mahaprabhu disappear, then Jiva Goswami Pad, came here in Dhamma and started Parikrama with Nityananda Prabhu, Balaram. Nityananda, the guide is Nityananda. Writing, Jagadananda Pandit also writing this thing, very secret point. And Dham Parikrama books written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur also, this kind of guidance you can get. And when Narottama Thakur came, they are all eternal parshad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Jiva Goswami Pad took darshan of Mahaprabhu first, when he was childhood actually, in Ramkaliga, you know. I did not explain this point. And this Narottama Thakur couldn't take darshan of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Still, Narottama Thakur is the eternal parshad of Gauranga. This point I've clarified before many times, that why I say that Narottama Thakur is eternal parshad of Gauranga, whereas Narottama Thakur coming much later. Why? Because Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale. Jena mean by whom? The desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was established. So in this sense, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also eternal parshad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami also eternal parshad. Madhavendu Puripada also eternal parshad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Why? Much before coming? Before coming, na? But still, somebody, Madhavendu Puripada, his disappearance day coming, I think, two days after, then I can discuss this point. Though Madhavendu Puripada came before Gauranga Mahaprabhu's appearance, still as per Siddhanta, Gaudiya Siddhanta, golden complexion, I mean Gauranga avatar was already there inside the heart of Madhavendra Puripad. That's why Madhavendra Puripad is the main foundation pillar of Gauriya Bhajan. In the way of Gauriya Bhajan, Madhavendra Puripad is the main pillar. main. Aidunde Dindyardanade Mathuranate can discuss this point after. So this way you see Narottama Thakur, eternal Parsad, Jiva Goswami, eternal Parsad, Srinivasa Acharya, eternal Parsad, they are all eternal Parsad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Though they are coming, somebody coming before, somebody coming off, after, this way, they are eternal Parsad. Actually, when Nityananda Prabhu guiding Jiva Goswami path, different place, that Parikrama, also Narahari Sarkar Thakur also writing some Parikrama about Damparikrama, writing Damparikrama, and about Nityananda Prabhu's Parikrama also, it is there, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur also writing so many topics of Damparikrama. So be careful, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was there in Puri, Jagadananda took permission from Gauranga Mahaprabhu, please permit me, I like to go to Vrindavan Dham. Jagadananda not in Vrindavan? Jagadananda not in Vrindavan? He like to go to Vrindavan? Or when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu praying in front of Sarvabhauma, every all devotees, please permit me, I like to go to Vrindavan. Is it true? They are not in Vrindavan? Mahaprabhu not in Vrindavan? Many times I told these secret topics. If you like to take darshan of Vrindavan Dham, you will have to go straightway up to Nilachal Dham. You will have to enter into Gambhira Mandir. You will have to concentrate, meditate on all leaders. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu under the guidance of a very strong spiritual master. Then and only then you can get permission to enter into Vrindavan. Otherwise, if you like to go there straightway up to Vrindavan, you have money, you can get plane ticket, up to Delhi you can get, or you can get a train ticket. Actually, trespassers will be prosecuted. If you like to enter into Dham forcefully, then trespassers will be prosecuted. You cannot get entry. You see, no green signal. Always Maya is there all around. Bhaktivinoda Thakur also writing. You like to see Dham? How you can see? You come here, you can see, oh, Mayapur Dham, so much hotel, no place to go. You can find this way. But actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur laughing. If Sarupshakti Kipa is fully there with you, then you are going to see Dham, transcendental Dham. No connection with this material world. This Dham is just loosely attached with this material world. This Dham is loosely attached with this material world. There is no connection with this material world. And there is one net. There is a net by Maya Devi. One net, like fish. Those who are fishing guard, they are going to catch fish. They arrange one net. After they give food, different kind of lucrative thing so that fish can come and can be caught in under, you know, under your conspiracy. So actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking, there is one net. Those who are elevated soul, Bhaktivinoda Thakur or eternal Parshad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, those who are Sadhan Siddha or Nitya Siddha, only they can have connection with them. No other people can see Dham. They can come forcefully in Dham. They like to stay here Dham. But Dham Aparad is big Aparad. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Dham Aparad is number one Aparad, big Aparad. There are so many points I have no time to discuss. Now what I mean to say, actually when Jagadananda took permission from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I like to go to Vrindavan, please give me permission. Mahaprabhu not at all ready to give permission. Because Mahaprabhu knowing, if Jagadananda is separated from me, just he going for one day, he can start crying. Where is Gaur? Where is Gaur? He cannot bear this kind of separation. But still, repeatedly, when Mahaprabhu not giving permission, he is requesting senior devotees like Sarvamatajajjo and these Rai Ramananda, please pray for me. Prabhu is not giving permission. They are praying on behalf of Jagadananda Prabhu. Jagadam like to see Vrindavan for one time. Please give permission. Mahaprabhu laughing. He cannot bear my separation. Acha, okay. I can allow him to go. Then he just going. Which way going? Just you see different forest, you see? Through which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to go to Vrindavan previously. Huh? Actually. No. After Sanatan did this, actually. Sanatan Goswami and Rupa Goswami, they all did parikrama. Actually, when Jagadananda wanted to go to Vrindavan, that time Jagadananda, actually he giving permission to Jagadananda, you can go and request, you can speak in front of Sanatan to arrange one nice solitary place for my bhajan. Actually, you see, this way, when Jagadananda Pandit going there, then actually, Mahaprabhu speaking, don't try to leave Sanatan for fraction of second. Always try to stay with Sanatan. Always try to stay with Sanatan all the time. Why? Why? What is the secrecy? Why Mahaprabhu repeatedly speaking in front of Sanatan, in front of Jagadananda? Jagadananda, you are going to Dham, but for a fraction of second, don't leave Sanatan. Be careful. Because you would be in trouble. Why? Sambandhagan Acharya, Sanatan. If there is no sense of relationship, if you don't grow any sense of relationship, you have no right to come in Dham. Though bonded soul coming, they are giving some sukriti, they are developing. In this sense, they can come. But actually, when they are coming to Dham, before that, if they took taken shelter under the lotus feet of some Sadguru, then and only then they can get power, if they are doing bhajan. If their saranagati inclination is perfect, then they can. This way, all the time, Jagadananda Pandit is staying with Sanatan, because Sanatan is the acharya of Sambandhagan Acharya. You see, this way, actually, repeatedly, we'll have to remember that Balaji Maharaj, Nityananda, is also Guru. Nityananda Baba also Guru. That's why in every fraction of second you will have to remember the lotus feet of Nityananda Prabhu. Amon nigrinno more kiba kiba kore ek Nityananda binu jagat majari. Who is there to deliver me? Nobody there. I am so fallen soul. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is written by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Purisher kit hoite muishe logishto. Jagai madai hoite muishe papishto, Purisher kit hoite muishe logishto. Mor naam jei loy tar paap hoy, Mor naam jei shune tar punno khoy. Amon nighinno more kiba kiba kore, Ek nittanunda binu jagat majare. What is the praying here? Actually, Krishnadas Goswami, Kaviraj Goswami, actually he is writing in Chaitanya Charitamrita, I am more and more, actually I am fallen soul, more and more fallen than Jagai Madhai. Because Jagai Madhai now enjoying full kipa of Gauranga, they are getting Dham Seva. So in, if you want to compare, I am low, I am much, you know, fallen soul, you see. And actually, I am also more and more fallen than the worm of stool. In stool, if you can form some sort of worm, but I am lower than that creature. So what kind of, you know, daina, what kind of, you know, humble attitude is expressing, you see. So, Jagai Madhai is a muite papishto, Purisher ki is a muishe logishto. And if somebody going to utter my name, if he is, he is committing paap, and who is going to hear my name, he is punya, he is getting some punya, he is going to, you know, lose punya. This is my condition. This is the condition of prema. Jiva Goswami is explaining. If you are going to get the service of Radha Krishna, under the guidance, under the guidance of Radharani, this kind of humble attitude is quite natural. Prabhupada speaking, under the guidance of Radharani, if you like to get seva, then this kind of humble attitude is quite natural. This is called Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan, very secrecy, quite natural. If you want to follow Radharani, this kind of humble attitude automatically. Like, you know, all our Guru Varga, they are showing this kind of attitude. Sirupa Manjuri Pado, Jar Dhan Sampado, who is Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami used to cry and sing this song. You know the reason behind it? You cannot understand. First you will have to come to Dham. Under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava, you will have to do Parikram. You can get some power. Then gradually you go on doing Harinam. Any kind of bhajan mode you are doing, nine folds of bhajan there, Sovanam, Kirtanam, Adi, everything. Even 64 types of bhajan mode there. Any bhajan you mean, you will have to do under the shelter of Sankirtan. Jiva Goswami Pad speaking, any bhajan you like to do, many bhajan mode there, do nine folds of bhajan, out of that five sorted by Mahaprabhu also, okay. But any bhajan you like to do, cleaning of temple, or if you like to do dham parikram, if you like to cook, if you like to go for madhukuri bhiksha, anything, whatever seva you are given, in plucking flower from garden, anything you like to do, any seva given to you by Guru Varga, mind it, you will have to memorize this point, you will have to do all seva under the guidance of Sankirtan. Sankirtan. Without Sankirtan you cannot do. That's mean Kishwayane Kibhajane Kimba Jagarane Ahar Nishichinta Krishna Balahabadane. It is the advice of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all the time, non-stop Harikirtan should be there in your life. Non-stop. While you are running, going anywhere, in train, bus, anywhere, all the time, non-stop Harikirtan is, you know, should be there. Non-stop. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was speaking, Kirtaniya Sadahari. Your Guru Maharaj also used to say, Kirtaniya Sadahari. Kirtaniya Sadahari means non-stop. There is no breakage. Not that I have done Sankirtan from 5 hours, from right from the morning time, I will have to take rest, Maharaj, for 5 hours. Not that. I have seen in the life of my Guru Maharaj, in the life of Guru Varga, Guru Maharaj is taking rest at night time, 12 o'clock, I see him tongue going on. No. Not a matter of joke. Tongue, dancing. Doing Harinam. Night time, you can see Maharaj taking rest, but still habituated. When expressing Sikh Leela, also coma state, they are also doing Kirtan this way. Midanga Vedana and doing Kirtan. How possible? So you will have to grow that kind of habit under the guidance of a very, you know, right spiritual master, you see. At the time of Prabhupada, you see, so many people from different parts of, you know, India used to come. But when they are doing Parikrama under the guidance of Prabhupada and all Guru Varga, after Parikrama is over, Prabhupada sitting in one place, everybody coming to take permission from Prabhupada. Prabhupada, please permit, we are going actually. We like to take permission from you. Prabhupada cannot speak even a single word. Just crying, shedding tears. They are begging, they are praying in front of Prabhupada, please permit us, we like to go to him. Prabhupada cannot speak even a single word. Only crying. Why? Prabhupada thinking, for at least 7 days, they have the chance to do Parikram, taking Mahaprasad, continuous Hariram, Sankirtan. They are getting the association of Guru Vaishnav. Now they are again going to jump into family life. It is like fire. Cheta darpana marjanam bhava mahadabagni nimapanam, you know. Again they are going to jump into family life. It is like fire. They cannot take rest. That's why Prabhupada cannot speak anything, only crying and crying. Now, actually, point is that different nine folds of bhakti, different parts, nine ayas line, you see, I can discuss this point tomorrow. Today, one special point is there, very, very, you know, serious point. One devotee from Switzerland, he is from Switzerland, he is, you know, putting some question in front of me, that Maharaj, how, what is there, how possible that this Purushottam Dham, he is speaking, the Purushottam Dham there, Jagannath Baladev Subhadra is there. So it is actually non-different from Dwarka Dham, he is speaking this way. And Vrindavan is more important than, you know, Purushottam Dham. So how everybody like to hear this point, what is some important, vital Siddhant about this? You can remember many times I told, actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking for Gaudiya devotees, those who like to do bhajan under the guidance of Rupa Goswami, anyway, if not at all under the guidance of Rupa Goswami, Raganuga bhajan also, or more half high Rupanuga bhajan, if at all they are going to you know, develop that kind of bhajan, for them Bhaktivinoda Thakur suggesting for Gaudiya devotees, this Purushottam Dham, Nilachal Dham is the topmost rasa khetra. Nilachal Dham is the topmost rasa khetra. What is that? We are in fallacy. But those devotees fighting, actually we heard Vrindavan, Jiva Goswami, but I think everybody, okay, nice, Vrindavan. But what about this Nilachal Dham? Be sure about that, that Nilachal Dham, it is written Dham Mahatya, it is Vaikuntha, okay. Four Dham, different, there in Himalaya, Bodhrikashram, Rameswaram, the Dham actually, Purushottam Dham, Dwarka Dham, four Dham, main, actually Dham, and Dham you know, you know, beyond your comprehension, you cannot imagine what Dham is. Repeatedly I told, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking before giving introduction to Dham Parikram, there is one nice net given by Maya, and on this net, we are all resting. But Guru Varga, they are just in Dham. You have no connection with Dham because you are on net. You know, you are on net. So, Mayadevi putting one net, you know, plotting nicely, so that we cannot get in connection with Dham. So, there is one net, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. So, Dham and Gram, village. Dham mean Dham, and Gram mean village, is totally different. Village mean all material facility, material conception, material heart, everything there. Everything there. So, you are in Dham. Even Gram. But when you can get total facility to realize the Dham Tattva, you can get the chance to see the beauties of Dham, then be sure Nityananda Prabhu is very happy with you. That's why blessing. That's why Northumbra Guru speaking, Ar kobe nitai chander koruna hoibe. Sangsa maksanamur kobe tuchya hobe. This way, Nityananda Prabhu, we have to pray unto the lotus way Nityananda, because Dham Tattva is also Nityananda Tattva. So you have to pray properly. Ar kabe nitai chander koruna haibe sansar vasana mor kabe tuchya. And again it is written there in Kirtan, nitair koruna habe braja radha krishna bhabe. Some acharya, I don't like to pass name, speak name, big acharya, some days passing remark that Nityananda cannot give, you know, a secret rasa. Then I was very unhappy. After that, when the Harikatha was over, I enter his room and pray, prostrate at Dandavat. I say, Maharaj, I like to get one Siddhanta from you. Nitayer Koruna Habe, Brajarada Krishna Pave. Is it not that I am going to get Rasa Tattva? Then he don't speak anything in front of me. It is a separate thing, he told me. Nitayer Koruna Habe, Brajarada Krishna Pave mean Nitayer Mercy, if you can get Nitayer Mercy of Nityananda, then you are going to get Rasa Tattva also. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami also praying in Jamatpur, his native village first. When some quarrel fighting took place between, Minketam Ramdas and his brother. He wanted to glorify Gauranga Mahaprabhu, don't like to glorify Nityananda. Then big fighting took place with Minketam Ramdas. He break his flute, Bangshi, break and go, very angry attitude. And Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is saying, maybe he is my brother in relation, material relation, but actually there was Sarvanash with him. And that very night, Nityananda came in dream and manifested big Ajahnulammita Bhujo, Nityananda Prabhu, in front of Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, putting his lotus feet on Nityananda Prabhu, on Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, and giving order. It is my order. You can get seva there in Dham. Now you go. Now you can go. You can get the association of, Roop, Sanatan, everybody there. You can go now. My blessing. You can get everything. Then morning time, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami took decision to go to Vrindavan. And he is praying and crying, by the mercy of Nityananda, I am getting Dham Seva, Dham Kripa, everything I am getting now. I am very lucky. I treat myself very lucky. Now, I like to switch over to this point, which is very vital. There is a big fighting. Whereas Bhaktivinoda Thakur, seventh Goswami, he is passing this kind of remark, that for Gauriya Bhajan, those who are going to enter into Rasa Tattva, for them, actually, Nilachal Khetra is topmost Rasa field. How is that possible then? Whereas, Jagannath Balaji Subhadra is there. It is almost actually Dharaka Tattva. Because you know from Puran, Skanda Puran, you can get this information. One day, Balaram and Krishna was there inside room. Rohini Ma wanted to explain in front of all Mahishis, all other wives of Vasudeva. They wanted to hear all about the glories of Vrindavan and their pastimes of Krishna. Then Rohini Ma started speaking. Balaram and Nityananda was outside, not inside, gate was closed. And the gate lady was Subhadra. Krishna Balaram like to get entry, Balaram, no, now we cannot get entry inside because some secret leela going on. So Rohini mother, she started speaking all about this Dham Tat, everything, their first time there. And by chance, they are hearing everything through door, shouting, crying. Then after that, Krishna Balaram and Subhadra, they melt body and get this kind of form. Narad Muni coming, Babu, what is your, this nice beauty, you see? Jagannath Balaji, all round eyes, nothing, you see? Then Krishna saying, it is my Nitya Sarup. Also, in this form, I am there in Nilachal Khetra, always, forever. You don't know. That's why this Sarup, my Jagannath Balaji Subhadra, is Nitya. And also you get information, it is from Dharika. You get. Now, point is that how we can, come to Siddhanta to adjust this point. Big point. Whereas Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking this way, and in different scripture we find Vrindavan in the topmost Rasa Tattva Khetra. And for we Gauriyas, why we can confess that Nilachal Dham is the topmost Khetra? This is the point. Now I like to go back to Gaur Lila. You can remember when Gauranga Mahaprabhu took sannyas and first he started running for Vrindavan. You can remember. through this Nidaya, Rudradip. Rudradip, then Nidaya Khetra, from there, night time, almost night, no, not, no. Gauranga Mahaprabhu crossed this river, Ganga, and gone forever. Though he is permanently there in Dham also, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Addhapiyo Sehi Lila Kare Gaur Rai, Kono Kono Bhagavane Dekhi Vare Pai. This Gaur Lila is permanent and Nitta. So some devotees can see, I can go back to Jaiva Dharma, I can give you one, you know, information that in Jaiva Dharma, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, two boys from Sinathpur. Jaiva Dharma, you gone through Jaiva Dharma? No? If not more, you will have to read Jaiva Dharma 100 times. My Guru Maharaj used to say, if not more, 100 times. Then you can realize something about Gaudiya Bhajan. Don't think it is a matter of joke. Actually, point is there, two young boys from Sinathpur, they used to come to Babaji Maharaj there in Shiva Sangan. Shiva Sangan, one Babaji Maharaj is there. He's doing all the time bhajan. All the time doing bhajan. Then when Babaji Maharaj give them diksha, harinam, diksha, everything, then that day they are arranging one festival, you see. They were going to go on feast, big feast was there. Prasadam, nice prasadam they offered, Babaji Maharaj offered to, you know, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Panchatattva. And when those devotees are taking prasadam there, then miracle. They are actually Sachimata, Malinima, all devotees. Those devotees are taking prasadam, they can see all there. I mean, Dham manifests in front of them. It is there in Jaiva Dharma. You don't read Jaiva Dharma. That is your disease, main disease. Is it in there? While they are taking prasadam, at the same time, by the mercy of Babaji Maharaj, this Dham appears in front of them. They are taking prasadam, they stop taking. They see all Dham, Malinima, Sita Thakurani, everybody there. Sivas Thakur, right? So, by the mercy of Babaji Maharaj, Dham was bound to manifest his sarup. You can remember also second point. When one, you know, businessman came in front of, the King Akbar came in front of Gosaiji, Swanathan Goswami, and wanted to do he wanted to give some service, seva, he wanted to do some seva. Swanatha said, no seva is there for you. Then he was very unhappy. Please, Gosai ji, give me some seva, we like to do. Then Gosai ji ultimately is thinking, well, you will have to repair that spot broken. I am going a staircase, I am going to Jamuna to take water, Delhi, for Madan Gopal seva. Some portion broken. So he can repair that thing. Akbar Gosai became very sentimental. He was very, you know, sorry to hear that kind of remark. Huh? I am emperor, I am big king. He like to, he is giving order to repair only some small portion. Huh? I am not beggar, so that I can go do the seva. Then Sanatan Goswami could realize this false ego. What portion? That portion. Sanatan Goswami indicating that portion. At the same time, when Sanatan Goswami indicating that Dham appear in front of Akbar Goswami. King Akbar become mad. He is crying. What I see now? Dibba, you know, stones, you know, supernatural stones from Golok Vrindavan, all fitted there. If I sell one stone, still I cannot. If I sell my whole kingdom, still I cannot arrange, because it is supernatural. Akbar Gosai crying, excuse me, I have some false ego that I can repair. It is aprakita dham, transcendental dham. I have no right to repair it. I have no power to repair it. Then Sanatana Gosai is smiling. So first of all, Guru Bhargava, what Guru Bhargava want to do? Kick on my head, kick mud on my chest to break my false ego. That is the first duty Guru Bhargu want to do. This seva Guru Bhargu like to do. Because otherwise, anyway, we are not going to leave false ego. You know, you can remember? Naraji is there, but still Nalkabar and Manigrib, they are so puffed up. They don't like to care that Naraji coming. Devarsi, they don't care. Then after that, what happened? Naraji, you don't care, you know? If you start insulting Sadhu Guru Vaishnav, then you know for sure you are day by day you are going down. If any Sadhu Guru Vaishnav is insulted by me somehow, directly or indirectly, a big penalty is there for me, waiting for me. Be careful. So then you see Naradji cursing, giving curse. You are so puffed up. See, you don't know how to pay respect to Sadhu Guru Vaishnav. So you have to take birth as trees there. They are crying, excuse us. No, I curse you, but you will have to take this birth. Jamal Arjun. But this much I can say, in Dapar Yuga, when Krishna coming, in his Bal Leela, somehow Krishna going to deliver you too, and you can get seva. They Nalkubar Menugriv, they are also getting nice seva. In Gopal Chambu is written there, nice, that, you know, they are getting seva inside Nandagram. Daily they are singing. Singing. When around 7 o'clock one Jamakirtan is there, Goposama Maje Hori Nana Gulo Kala Nana Guno Kalahari, a resident there. When Krishna taken inside the office of Nandagram, Nando Maharaj, different artists they are coming, somebody singing, somebody acting, Sangha making some nice joke, Krishna enjoying this. After that, Jasodama calling, after that taking rest, after that Krishna gone to forest for doing Leela. That time, Madhukanta or Snigdhakanta, two names. Madhukanta or Snigdhakanta, they took. So they started doing seva permanently. They are inside Nandagram, you see, their luck, you see. Naradji now become very angry. If those sadhu, some sadhu is very angry with you, still you are lucky. Because they are going to give cards. That cards is also equal to blessing. Actually, anyway, you are not going to get the darshan of Krishna. But as and when Naradji giving cards them, then in Gajendra Mokshan also, Huhu Gandharva, pulling the leg of Deval Rishi. Oh, you are acting as crocodile. Hey! You will have to become crocodile. Then he become crocodile. We're crying. Okay. Someday you can get the mercy of Hari. That Hari in Gajendra Moksha I can discuss after. Not this point. This way, he got Kipa from Hari. From Naradji actually. Oh, yes, cursing. It's not actually curse, actually. Blessing. More than blessing. This way, you see, Naraji now curse them. What Naraji did? Naraji speaking, Asato Semadandhasya Daridham Paramanjanam. Many times I discuss this point. Asato, those who are concentrating on evil thing, I mean material thing, Asato, they are Asato. For them it is very good if they become very, very, very poor. Then they cannot get any facility, they can cry. That is one kind of kajal, you see, surma. You know, in eyes you are giving kajal, you see, black. You know, childhood mother used to give me also, she used to give also. After that you can go to play. So this way, Naraji speaking, it is one kind of, you know, applying kajal in eyes, so that you can develop your sight. More powerful side you can grow. You see? So more powerful you can. Huh? So this way, Naraji speaking, if they become very, very poor, they can, their vanity can vanish. And same thing, you know, Kunti Devi speaking. Janmai sajya suto sivi redhamana madahappamana naiva arhatiya vidatumba itama kinchana gocharam. Only those who are niskinchan. Niskinchan mean, if you have no property other than the lotus feet of Krishna, then you are niskinchan. Though Prabhupada having 64 branches of Gauriya Math, he is Acharya, but still he is niskinchan. Because he thinks, I have nothing. Only the lotus feet of Krishna is the property. Those who are niskinchan, for them, lotus feet of Krishna is the only property. So they are niskinchan. Follow? Niskinchan, this. And when Krishna talking with whom? I mean, Dwarka, you know, first wife of Krishna, Rukmini. That time Krishna joking with, it seems that Krishna joking, where Krishna speaking all the truth. Then when Rukmini, in front of Rukmini, Krishna speaking, see, I am very niskinchan. Aham niskinchan, aham niskinchan, niskinchana janair priya. I am myself this niskinchan, and those who are niskinchan sadhu, only they can love me, no other people. Rukmini laughing, you are niskinchan? Infinity Brahmanda you have? Infinity treasure? Rukmini speaking? Krishna saying, believe me. Believe me. I am not speaking lie. Only, the lotus feet of Radharani is my property. That's why I am niskinchan. Krishna is niskinchan. Why? Because the lotus feet of Radharani is the only property for Krishna. That's why Krishna is niskinchan. Why we want to become niskinchan? We want to get the property of lotus feet of Krishna as a property. Then you can become niskinchan. So niskinchan, you see, this way, Krishna is 100% niskinchan. Same Leela Krishna speaking in front of all Gopikas. Krishna, we like to serve Durvasa Muni is coming there. There Narayana Goswami also making one mod there. Durvasa, you know, Rishi Durvasa Mat, Gauriya Mat. They are at the bank of Jamuna, where you are crossing Jamuna River, this side to that side, Gokula this side. You can get the chance to see that Durvasa Mat. That spot, very spot, where Durvasa Muni came in Brajadam, then all Brajagopikas, they like to serve, you know, Durvasa Muni. Then they cannot go because there is no boat. Water is there. How to go with all prasadam, everything? They like to take all different kind of food. You know, they like to cross river. They are requesting Krishna, how to cross? How to cross river? There is no boat. How to go? We are thousands of Gopikas. They like to cross river. Then Krishna speaking, If I am 100% Brahmachari, then you can request in from Jamuna. Jamuna can give you. Ha! You are Brahmachari? Then the whole Gopika laughing. You don't believe? You go in front of Jamuna and request. If Krishna is 100% perfect Brahmachari, then give us way, hey Jamuna. Then they requesting it, Jamuna giving way. They are going to Durvasa Muni serving. They are taking Durvasa Muni taking lot of prasadam. Tons of prasad I am taking, prasad. And while coming back, they are also requesting in front of Durvasa. Oh, Durvasa, see, now we like to go back to, you know, our place. How to go? Can you give one, you know, way out? You can go in front of Durvasa. If you say Durvasa is Durvabuji, if I am taking the juice of Durva, Durva ras, Durva, you know, in grass, I am taking only juice of Durva. Then Jamuna can give way. You are taking lot of prasadam. You are taking lot of prasadam. How is that possible? I can believe you. Say, okay, you cannot believe me. But you go in front of Jamuna. Then okay, she can give. Then they are getting praying. Then this way some fallacies there. Now I like to come back to this vital point. As per Skanda Puran, the Dwarka Leela, just I spoke a few minutes ago, Jagannath Balada Subhadra. Dharkatatta. Dharkatatta is there. But you can remember when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas and started running from Vrindavan, Nityananda Prabhu playing trick and he is teaching all coward boys. If Prabhu asking you, where is Vrindavan? You can say just opposite way, this way, so that Prabhu can come back here. Then Gauranga Mahaprabhu asking, oh boys, how to go to Vrindavan? Which way? This way you go. Nityananda Prabhu playing. Then Nityananda Prabhu running, ultimately coming at the bank of Ganga. Whereas, already Nityananda Prabhu sending information to Advaita Goswami with clothes and everything, and boat, waiting there. Then Gauranga Mahaprabhu watching Advaita Goswami, Goswami, how you know I am in Vrindavan? How you come here in Vrindavan? Then Advaita Goswami speaking, actually, where you are staying, it is Vrindavan. Now we are lucky that you are coming to Navadvip Dham. Navadvip? How is that possible? I am going to Vrindavan. Then Nityananda speaking all rubbish again, playing trick with me. He is misguiding me. So, my God, I cannot go to Vrindavan. I am very sorry. Then actually, Advaita Goswami speaking, actually you like to take bath in Jamuna? You are now taking bath in Jamuna. Because Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati, three confluences there in Navadvip. This side Jamuna, this side Jamuna, this side Ganga, and Saraswati is also there. Three confluences, secretly. So, you are 100% sure you have taken bath in Jamuna. And we are lucky you have come to Navadvip Dham. You will have to go to my house to take prasadam there. Then Gauranga Mahaprabhu going there. Now, who is Advaita Goswami? Who is Advaita Goswami? Mahavishnu Jagatkarta Maya Yaja Srijati Yadaha Tasyavatara Evayam Advaita Acharya Isva Iswaraha. So, Advaita Goswami speaking lie? Advaita Goswami, you are 100% sure you are now in Vrindavan. Where you are staying, it is Vrindavan. Even Sarup Goswami Rai Ramananda discussing inside Gambira Mandir, I already told. If you like to get entry into Vrindavan Dham, you will have to go to Gambira and get the taste of Gaurlila there. Then you can go and get entry into Vrindavan Dham, otherwise not. You cannot get entry. This way, now point is there. Actually, when Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking, this is the topmost rasa pita for Gauriyas. So, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming to Vrindavan, now, Nilachal Dham, playing there, manifesting Lila. Do you think it is Dwaraka? When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going inside temple, then it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, when going to take darshan of Jagannath, staying behind Garur. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always used to see that Krishna playing on fruits and Radhika embracing Radhika. Right? In Chaitanya Charitamrita repeatedly it is written. When Gauranga Mahaprabhu going to take darshan of Jagannath, all the time it is written there that when looking at Jagannath crying, we can see there is no eye, no ears, no hand, no legs, nothing. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was he? Playing on fruits. Krishna playing on fruits and embracing Radharani. We Gauriyas must develop that kind of darshan. When Advaita Goswami doing parikram, then Mahaprabhu speaking, when you are doing parikram, when you are going backside to do parikram, that much time you are losing the darshan of Krishna. You cannot have the chance. This kind of accuracy Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to say. All the time. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came past, in Atharanala, took darshan of Jagannath Chakra, and seeing Krishna, Bal Gopal dancing there, and get fainted, fall down. Then again, dancing and crying, coming here up to Jagannath temple, somehow managed to enter into Jagannath temple, then he ran to embrace Jagannath. Because he can see Nandanandan Krishna is there inside Jagannath temple. But somehow gets stuck up with some, you know, barrier there and fall down, get faint. Then after that, those pandas, they are very, very angry. Hey, where is... Then Sarvamurti says, don't speak anything. Why? His symptom is very high. Then he give direction to all his, students, to carry Jagannath up to his home. He was taken, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, taken inside Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's room there. And in the meantime, Nityananda Prabhu and all Advaita Goswami, all devotees, they are coming here. They are taking information that one Ajahnilam Vidabhuyo Ganakavadato. One Mahaprabhu came by symptom, by discussion. They are discussing among themselves. One sannyas is coming. We cannot describe, but his Baba, his, complexion. Oh, it must be Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then they took decision to go up to Sarvamurad house. They are less interested to go inside Jagannath temple first. Be careful, this is also Raganuga Bhajan. Ramananda Rai also, when he came from his, Dakshin Bharat, Vidyanagar, Mahaprabhu was going, you took darshan of Jagannath? No. First I come to you. Why? You have done mistake. You should have gone there first to take darshan of Jagannath. You have missed making mistake. Then Rai Ramananda speaking, Prabhu, I cannot pass any remark about that, but this much I can say, one chariot is driven by you, that chariot can go as per your gesture. So, you are sitting in my heart, you are giving me direction to come up to you, that's why I am coming to you. I don't calculate how to go to Jagannath temple, I don't know, you are there? You are sitting, you are driving the chariot. Sarir, that my body is chariot, you wrath. So you are guiding. So I took decision to come to you first. I don't calculate how to go to Jagannath temple. It is Jagannath darshan is, your darshan is more than Jagannath. No, don't speak like that. I am bonded soul actually. Mahaprabhu speaking. This way, you see, they first went to inside Sarvamurti Jaja's house. They are doing big Sankirtan. Shaddha sadhan tattva je kichu sakal Harinam Sankirtana paibe. Same advice Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, but you don't like to hear it. That is the main disease. When actually speaking in front of Sanatan, when speaking in front of Tapan Mishra, when went to Bangladesh, I rolled this point in Puri, Nilachal Dham. Same advice. Shaddha Thadan Tattva, anything you like to get, you can get through Sankirtan. If you like to ignore Sankirtan, pass away Sankirtan, Kirtaniya Sadahari, then there is no possibility of success. Cannot get. Now point is that, repeatedly I told about transcendental sound vibration. What about transcendental sound vibration? What about transcendental sound vibration? What do you mean? When Madhavendu Puri was speaking, Ha Vrindavan, Ha Mathuranath, with this word, Vrindavan Dham is itself there. You know, what do you mean by transcendental Dham, transcendental sound? Transcendental sound vibration means, what sound going to mean that is equal to that sound, that dham. Suppose the sound Ha Vrindavan is pronounces this sound. And that Vrindavan is equal to that sound. You cannot believe it. It's quite impossible to believe because logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. That is the main problem. It is beyond human comprehension. Anything spoken in front of you, you first start playing your head. Oh, it must be like this. Anything, any Siddhanta, any Guru Varga, any sadhu speaking in front of you, you like to first play your brain. Oh, it must be like this. That is your main disease. If you can go out of this disease someday, then you can feel that the sound coming out of the lotus leaf of any sadhu is equal to the sound he wanted to mean. Follow. Aidindyardhanadai Mathuranat, with this word, I can discuss this point. Madhavendra Puripadde coming. It is a word by Radharani. Somehow it appeared in the tongue of Madhavendra Puripadde. It is written Siddhanta. It is a saying of Radharani. Somehow, I don't know, we don't know how this came in the tongue of Madhavendra Puripadde. So you see, while doing Rathayatra, I can discuss this point. While doing Rathayatra, it is the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taking Krishna from Dwarka up to Vrindavan. I can discuss this point tomorrow. Very nice philosophy. Now point is that whenever Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there with full Baba, you should not fight on this point. You should not find over this point that this is not Vrindavan. Because Advaita was already. So we Gaudiya devotees, we are following whom? Gauranga Mahaprabhu? We are following Nityananda? Whereas Nityananda Prabhu, whereas Advaita was speaking, it is Vrindavan. Maybe it is Dwarka Dham for those who are doing bhajan, up to that level. I mean, Aishwarya Marga, they are doing 100%. Because Ramanuja Acharya, you can remember, came here, in Nilachal. Ramanuja Acharya, the big Acharya from South India, came in Nilachal Dham to rectify, to re-establish Seva mode. Then overnight, Jagannath throwing him out of Nilachal Dham, he find himself in Kurmaketra, with bedstead, everything, bed, everything, chair, everything there. He gone there. In morning time, oh Krishna, how I am here? Overnight? It takes days, months to cross by walking. Now Krishna, Jagannath throwing him, go! You like to rectify seva here? I like to approve this seva. Even there's Pundarik Vidyanidhi. Someday he is watching Jagannath. He watching, they are not washing cloth. Before washing, they should not give this cloth to Jagannath. Yes, very dirty. So. Then in night time, Jagannath Balaram came slapping. Tap, tap. Slapping. All the swelling, you see, morning time he cannot come outside. What happened? I don't like to speak. Jagannath and Balaram came and beating me. Who are you to pass remark about this? You are going to find fault with Panda? This seva approved by me. Who are you? Then Pundarik Vidyanidhi could understand, oh my God, I should not pass any remark here. Aishwarya Gyan, is not, applicable here. Ramanujaja also. Ramanujaja came here. The overnight he was sent outside Nilachalda. We go outside. Still today, he can get the influence of Ramanujaja. Still today. Ramanujaja was sent outside. Jagannath not ready to accept Ramanujaja's, procedure of seva. I like to get that kind of, who are you to pass remark? But one point is that Ramanujaja is very big influential acharya. So still today you can find the influence of Ramanujaja. How? You can look at top. You can see the tilak of Ramanujacharya. Jagannath, you see, just their wheel, chakra is there. Just down that you can find one tilak of. You see? Don't see? You are blind? Never see? Ramanujacharya tilak is there. So influential, powerful acharya, you see. For Ramanujacharya, for other acharyas, it can be, you know, Vaikuntha. But not for Gaudiya devotees. There should not be any fighting over this point. Where Gauranga Mahaprabhu is there with all Baba, that is Vrindavan for us. Repeatedly I can explain Gauranga Leela. And through Gauranga Leela, I like to give you a feelings of Raganuga Bhaja. This is my topics. All 5, 6, 10 days I am discussing this. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu jumping into Samundra, see, that is also Vrindavan Leela. That is also Vrindavan Leela. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu caught inside net, when after Sankirtan expressing some, you know, consciousness, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, why you call me here? I was watching Leela of water game of Radha Govinda and all sakis, they are playing in Yamuna, and suddenly you catch me here? Why you disturb me? So what do you mean to say? It's Vrindavan Leela. Inside Gambira, while Chaitanya Mahaprabhu discussing all this rasa tattva, everything with Rama, it is also Vrindavan Leela. Not Dharika Leela. Yes, Dharika Leela for common people. Not for Gauriya devotees, they are actual devotees. They have entry inside this Gauriya philosophy. Getting full kripa of Nityananda. For them, it is not Dharika. Follow? Though special Leela you can find while Ratha Yatra going on, that time one special Baba is there with Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu expressing this Baba. And we are checking, that is for the excellent feelings of separation. That's why Mahaprabhu is expressing this Leela. While daily Mahaprabhu taking darshan of Jagannath, it is one Vrindavan Leela. But when we want to get Jagannath from Jagannath temple up to Gundicha spot, that is also a Leela expressed there in Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam, there also you can get there. Same Leela. This Baba Mahaprabhu expressing this Leela. That long after long time we have the chance to take Krishna, we are dancing and singing, we can take Krishna. After. And what all Chaitanya Mahaprabhu watching everywhere? There is forest in Balagandi, everywhere Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Vrindavan. Actually, at the bank of Jamuna, there is trees and, you know, this way Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving this feeling. So, up to Gundicha Mandir, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dancing and, you know, expressing ecstatic feeling that I am lucky, I am getting the, I mean Krishna inside Vrindavan. A feeling of separation, always crying. A feeling of deep separation. Vrindavane chalo jai Jagannath. Oi Gauriya devotees, my Guru Maharaj, Santu Goswami Maharaj. You are not lucky to watch that kind of kirtan. What kind of feeling? Srila Bhakti Bhuvan Puri Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti to Madhav Goswami Maharaj, Santu Goswami Maharaj, full troops. They are singing, they are dancing, everybody crying. Same feeling. Because when they are singing, same, you know, circumstances there. They have the direct feeling, well, now we are separated from Krishna. Now we are lucky, we are taking Krishna up to Vrindavan. It's very nice thing. So this way, I can give you numerous example, give you evidence, I can prove that as and when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there, expressing any Baba, when we have the chance to go through that Baba, be sure this is Vrindavan. even in Hera Panchami day. You can remember Hera Panchami day. Lakshmi Devi, the goddess of appliances, coming with stick and everything. Full troops coming to beat the sevak of Jagannath Pandas. Hey, why you take Jagannath here and lock here? We like to check Jagannath there. Otherwise, we can beat you. Then Jagannath, they start beating night time. Is the Hera Panchami day. Very nice Leela. Those Panda, they are crying. At morning time, you go, we can send Jagannath there. We can come. This way. There, Raja Prataparudra now arranging situation so that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda, Swarup Goswami, Rai Ramananda, they can have the nice chance to watch this Leela. Because heavy ras. By the instruction of Radha Prataparudra, those devotees, they are arranging to seat them in a proper place so that they can have the chance to watch that Leela. That very time, I can discuss this point day after day, long discussion. That time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asking Swarup Goswami and Sivas Pandit. Swarup Goswami and Sivas Pandit, they are discussing some point. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in between them sitting and laughing. Naradji with the Baba of Dwarakabab, I mean some appliance, I mean, though in Nitya Leela, in Gaur Leela is also Rasa Tattva is there. If you twofold actually. Naradji, you know, actually he is the avatar of Narad, Sivas. So actually Naradji can go anywhere. So there is no barrier. He can go, enter into Vrindavan, go to Dwarka, go to Mathura, anywhere. But actually that time, some discussion took place in between, you know, Naradji and Swarup Goswami. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu laughing, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saying, Swarup is Suddha Brajavasi. You cannot fight with him regarding Siddhanta Tattva. Your tattva is there, you are, your mood is just, you know, influenced by, you know, Aishajya tattva. So you are passing this kind of remark. But inside Vrindavan, in one part of Vrindavan, whole Vaikuntha Aishajya cannot stay there. Even one small part of Vrindavan, whole Vaikuntha Aishwarya you can put, but still it is, you cannot compare with Vrindavan Tattva. Vrindavan is just the point is that Vrindavan is overflowing Rasa Tattva and suppressing these affluences, and just opposite there in your different place, you see. In Vrindavan, you can see Rasa Tattva. By Rasa Tattva is super flowing. It's always flowing. Rasa Tattva. So appliances cannot show his power. That's why always and every time you can get this taste. But be careful, there are Krishna and Radharani doing Leela there. We know all Leela pastimes of Krishna is there. But we are more lucky, because we want to get Rasa Tattva under the guidance of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Some new devotees coming from different parts, first they put question, why Maharaj in all Gauriya Math there is Gauranga Mahaprabhu? Why not Radha Krishna alone? With Radha Krishna, always Gauranga Mahaprabhu. What's the reason behind it? Why? Because we like to get this Rasa Tattva under the guidance of Gauranga. That's why all Guru Varga, they are establishing Gauranga. Sometime Gaur Nityananda separately, in separate part, Radha Govinda. So Radha Govinda doing Leela is Rasapit, okay. But when Gauranga Mahaprabhu expressing this kind of Brajabhav there inside this, you know, Nilachal Dham, it is more important for us. It is more and more important for us, because we cannot get that kind of taste what we can get under the guidance of Gauranga. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing this way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing this way. Because sense of fellow, you know, separation you can get maximum there in Nilachalam. More and more you can get. Because whole day and night Prabhupada crying and you know, enjoying this kind of mood. And it is written there, we'll have to do Gauriya Bhajan under the guidance of Gauranga. It's written there. Sabhakti bhyo shudhyam nija bhajana mudram padisan sachaitanya kingme punaropidi swarya swati padam. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can show lotus seed? Because each and every action of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is suitable for Raganuga Bhajan. I can explain this point day after day. So, the devotee from Switzerland, Radha Madhav, he is hearing Harikatha for a long time in front of me. At present he is Vrindavan. So he is putting this question in front of me. So today I think I can give complete answer to him. It's complete? Or you have any doubt about it? You have any doubt about it? If you have any doubt, I can... Have any doubt? No, it's okay. Huh? Then actually, now if you have any other question, you can put in front of me. Tomorrow I can discuss about nine, Deepa, Tata, what kind of seva we can get everywhere. And at the same time, side by side, I can discuss Gaurlila, so that I can get the feeling of Raganuga Bhajan. Why we should follow Gaurlila? Because ultimately it can give direct frame. Follow. Any question you have? Vancha kalpadarosya ke pasindu bevachupati thanang pavane bhavishna bhyo namo. Any question, Maharaj? If you have, no? I already give answer, but still, if you have any question, you can.
Very clear.
Very clear. Yeah, by your blessing, actually. Actually, if any question you can put. Actually, you see, in Navadvip Dham, it is also a place of Rasatattva, big Rasatattva. Because here you can get the feelings of separation from Gauranga. In this sense, the Shetadvip, also because side by side, when Gauranga Mahaprabhu doing Leela here, when Gauranga Mahaprabhu gone to Nilachal Dham, then those Brajavasis, they are also Brajavasis. Those who are staying in Navadvip from heart, they are also Brajavasis. They have their different kind of feelings there. They are also getting this kind of separation, feelings of separation. This is also nice. I was discussing this point in Puri, you know. Every time, every year, they are going to Nilachal Dham, all devotees, the old, you know, old ladies, you know, old man, small child, you know, ladies, everybody, they full troops, they are going. Where? Up to Nilachal Dham. Now you calculate the distance from Navadvip, Shantipur, here, there, they get together in one place. Then under the guidance of Sivananda, they are going. How much time it takes? What is the distance? Around 700 kilometers. Around. Because that time, you have facility now, state way you can get train and go. Whereas in zigzag way, minimum 700 kilometers. And 700 kilometers, if you can calculate, every day with old ladies, old men, if they try to go up to Puri, if they average 20 kilometers, they move every day. Because all their cooking prasadam, two times, begging, it will take time. Morning time they are doing bhajan. So maximum 20 kilometers. Then 700 kilometers divided by 20 kilometers. How much it come? Around
35 days.
35. Then you see? So you see 35 days. 35 days on minimum. And maybe they cannot move 20 kilometers. It's dangerous. The forest is that. So this way, they are moving. And they are staying there for 4 months. So calculate, minimum calculation, 2 months for going, 2 months for farming, 2 months, 4 months staying there, Chaturmasa. Minimum calculation, because the road was very congested, full of forest, you see. It is quite impossible. Nowadays, you can go and do Govardhan Parikrama very easily. But can you imagine? Imagine at the time of Sanatan, what was the road condition? Full of forest and thrown, kata, all the time. It's very dangerous. So, approximately 2 months if you calculate, 2 months going, 2 months coming, and 4 months staying there, Chaturmasa. So, 8 months gone. And 4 months they are staying there, they are Bhujavasi. They are Navadvipasi, they are Bhujavasi. They are crying, where is go, where is go? This kind of feeling always there. So, now you try to understand their position. 2 months gone, 2 months coming and going. 4 months. 4 months staying there. 8 months gone. So they are Grihastha. They are Grihastha? Not. They are not Grihastha. So they have their feeling. So this way you should think. And while they are taking permission from Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Gauranga Mahaprabhu cannot speak anything. Only crying. Prabhu, please permit us. We are going to our home. Prabhu crying and crying, cannot answer anything. Then Sarup Damodar, Rai Ramana Prabhu, if you are crying yourself, automatically there is tremendous attraction there with you. Nobody can avoid that kind of attraction. At the same time you are crying, how they can go home? Their heart can crush down. Don't cry. Allow them to go to their home. This way Prabhu crying and giving permission. So you see the feeling. This is also Navadvipa. You, Gauriya, if you are Gauriya, you will have to get both feeling. Navadvipa, Setadvip, this feeling. What Mahaprabhu doing in morning time, 4 o'clock, in Siva Sangan, crying. This feeling you should get. And same Leela going there in Vrindavan. Now I cannot speak. I can go on discussing this point. Through Gaur Leela, how you can get the feelings of Raganuga Bhajan. This is my topics. To especially I discuss this point, this question sent by Radha Madhava Ubar email. So I give answer. Now if you have any question then I can speak, otherwise I can stop. I will have to go a long way. Okay. Dandavada. Now you can do some kirtan, I can go away. Manchakalpatarush.